So why aren't we living in abundance? Besides the unbelief, if I can describe it another way, it's like your heart is not aligned. Okay? It's out of alignment. It's kind of like a car. You know, you've driven a car that's out of alignment. It's going to pull one side or the other. You know, if you're out of alignment, it's going to go to one side. It's exactly like your heart. Okay? If you've got unbelief in your heart, then you're out of alignment. And you're getting pulled in one direction. And that direction is the carnal mind, the carnal thinking. Okay? And so your heart's out of alignment. And what is the heart? Okay, the heart is your spirit and your soul. Okay, you are a spirit. You don't have a spirit, you are a spirit. We've talked about this. Okay, you're a spirit. You have a soul. Okay, your soul is your mind, will, and emotions. Okay, so we've got to transform that mind so that it lines up with the spirit man. Okay, your spirit is perfect. If you gave your life to Jesus Christ, you are a new creation. You have been reborn. You're brand new. But your mind, will, and emotions, your soul has to be renewed daily. And it's not a one-time thing. It's a lifetime. It's a lifetime process. You're not going to get there by doing this one day. You've got to do it over and over and over and over. Repetition and renewing your mind. Okay? And we're going to talk about some of those things. So the spirit and the soul, the spirit is where God dwells. If you're a born-again Christian, his spirit dwells within your spirit. He speaks to you through your spirit. Okay? Getting your heart in alignment. What's that take? It's 2 Corinthians 5:17. 2 Corinthians 5:17 basically says if you're in Christ, you're a new creation. So that's going to be renewed. Okay? And we'll go ahead and go through that. So therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. And if we go a little bit further, in 18 it says, now all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ, and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. So we are a new creation. And the only way you're going to tear down that unbelief is to target your self-limiting beliefs. Okay, now how do you target your self-limiting beliefs? And what are they? The first thing, you've got to identify what your self-limiting beliefs are, your self-limitations. So it comes first by identification. Second, you've got to become disassociated with that limited belief. You know, if you've got limitations in your life, and we all do, okay, first step is to recognize, identify what that is, okay? And I know there's a lot of stuff, a lot of gaps that I haven't touched on, and just for the, you know, for the time, but we've got to, and maybe we can do this some other time, but we've got to recognize how we identify and how we disassociate ourselves from those self-limiting beliefs. So you've got the identification, you've got the disassociation, and then you've got the antidote, and then you've got to employ your new empowering belief. Okay? So, number one is identification. Find out what your limitations are. Number two is disassociate yourself with the limitation. Now, how are you going to do that? That comes by meditation on the Word of God. Okay, if you're meditating on the Word of God, you are going to you're going to see yourself in a new light. You're going to see Jesus coming into your situation and transforming you out of that situation. That's what disassociation means. It means meditating on the Word of God, see yourself removed from the situation. Once you see that in your mind, create that image. Okay, then it's time to apply the antidote. So the antidote is scriptures. Okay, you find the scriptures that are just the opposite of your limitations. Okay, if it's lack, then find scriptures on prosperity. Okay, if it's depression, then you want to find scriptures that get rid of that depression. And then you take those scriptures and you meditate and you confess. Okay, you got to confess. It comes with confession, and you don't just say words. That's not confession, okay? And there's, I talked about earlier, giving my message, I used to absorb myself and read these books and stuff, and self-help and that. And confession, according to these experts, is a true confession is going to be, you're going to make they call it the three P's, and you got to make it positive, you got to make it personal, and you've got to make it present tense, okay? So when you confess, you got to make it personal, you got to make it present tense and positive, okay? Those three. So put it kind of in perspective, if you're dealing with cancer, you're not going to confess, I am being healed by the Word of God, or I am being healed of this cancer. That's not right. It's already been done. You've already been healed. Okay. So what you've got to say to yourself, what you've got to confess, is that I am healed. I am healed. Jesus has taken it all on the cross. Okay. And so you've got to learn to confess. And make it personal, make it present tense, make it positive. Okay? So that's gonna be finding the antidote. So you're confessing the Word of God, you're confessing the scriptures that you found to get rid of that unbelief. And then the last thing is employ the empowering belief. So what we've essentially done is taken, say we've got a table, okay? What we're doing is knocking the legs out from that table, okay? The table is unbelief. What we want to do is knock the legs out of that, out from under that table, and we're rebuilding it from the inside out so that we manifest the power of God, okay, on the outside. So we're building new empowering beliefs to replace the unbelief. Okay, we're getting rid of that unbelief and renewing our mind, the Word of God, creating new beliefs. And there's a lot of stuff that I'm missing here, but the point is we're creating new beliefs and we're replacing those with your unbelief, okay, your limitations. So, everything that I've said so far boils down to this, okay? And it's in Proverbs 23:7. It's the first part of it. And it says, I'm just going to get there. Basically it says, for as he thinketh in his heart, so is he. What that means is whatever you got going on in your heart, it's going to manifest on the outside of you. If you think you're church, and you're just playing the game of church, okay, because for whatever reason in your mind you think it's a good thing to do, okay, you're only deceiving yourself, okay? You're deceiving yourself by doing it. You've got to change the inside. You've got to change your mind and renew it with the Word of God. Okay? Once you do that, that thing manifests on the outside. And so your new thing, is going to be within mind with the Word of God. Okay? So all the steps that I've showed to you can find that in Corinthians 10, 3 through 5. Okay? So if you go to 2 Corinthians 10, 3 through 5. Not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think of anything as being from ourselves, but our sufficiency is from God, who also made us sufficient as ministers of the new covenant, not of the letter, but of the Spirit. For the letter kills, but the Spirit gives life. But if the ministry of death written in the grave on stone with glory, so that the children of Israel could not look steadily and up in the wrong place. It'll come to me in a minute. Basically, what we're doing in this passage, we're taking every thought captive. Okay, and what I described to you in identification and disassociation and the antidote and pouring your new power of belief, it all boils down to this scripture, and that's taking every thought captive. And the word captive comes from two words. Okay? Sword and conquer. Sword and conquer. Kind of see where I'm going with this. Okay? We take our thoughts captive, okay, by the sword, which is the Word of God. Okay? The sword is the Word of God. We take our thoughts captive by the sword of the Word of God and conquer. Okay? So we're taking our unbelief thoughts captive. And we're conquered, so that all we have left is belief. We can move this off. Okay? Whatever it is in your life that's holding you back, identify it. And take the steps to remove it, so that belief is manifested and you can move forward in the kingdom of God and be blessed and partner with it. Make sense? Let's go ahead and bow our heads.